Northwest. First man and first woman. Long ago, in the far, cold north, in the land of the Aleut people, first man and first woman lived in the world. They lived in a village among other people, for they had been there some time, but there were not many animals then. Mostly small animals, so you had to do a lot of hunting and fishing to eat, unless as a group you could get the great whale, but that's another story. First man and first woman were hungry. It had been a long, cold winter. Spring had not yet really come, but the grasses were peeking up. So first man went for a walk, for a long, winding walk. A long, a long, winding walk. And when first man was far out enough, away from the village, on the ice, to where it looked good to him, he cut a hole in the ice. And he looked down into the dark water, too black to see. And he reached down, 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 down. And he pulled up caribou, a big, pale, furred animal that shook itself off and ran towards the village. First man lost no time. Quick with his spear like that, whoosh, and caribou was down. He used the rope, normally tied to the spear, for when they went to hunt the great whale, and used it to tie up the body and drag it back to the village. First woman was very impressed.
Huh. She's big. We can feed the whole village like this. That will be good.
And so she butchered caribou as carefully as she had ever cut any tiny fish, stored some meat, buried some meat, set some out, called the village, and used that fine fur to make first man a fine new parka and fine new mukluks. And the village ate well. She was sweet like that, caribou, and they slept good. But you know caribou don't like to be alone, eh? And so out of that hole, left open by first man, wandered two more caribou. And when the villagers awoke in the morning and they saw this, they got excited. Now we can all have new clothes, warm clothes, eh? And good meat to store. And they were happy. But it did not last. Because caribou do like to be together. They kept coming to the village, and before you knew it, there wasn't a blade of grass to be seen anywhere. Nothing that would have been gathered had even a shoot. The caribou were nibbling at the thatch around people's houses. You could hardly get down the street of the village. What little road there was. Whoop! Pardon me. Caribou, coming through. No one knew what to do except for first woman. And she went on a long, winding walk, following the trail that first man had made, until she came to the hole in the ice. And she reached down, 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 and pulled up. Hey, a mouse. Wolf, who shook himself off, sniffed the air, and ran towards the village in search of caribou. And before you know it, there were several fewer caribou. So first woman brought back